Dear students, in the last videos we ever discussed about dictionaries. What is a dictionary? What are the different methods work on a dictionary? And now we'll see what is the role of a dictionary on the files. We also know what is a file, how to create a file and how to work with the file. Open the file based on the name which we need to open and the mode in which it has to open. So whenever we are providing the mode as a read mode, it is mandate. We don't know whether this file is previously existing or not. Then it has to be written with a try block. If it is a write mode, then it need not to be in a try block because it creates the new file if it is not available. So that's why it's been written with a try and except block. Whether the file already available, then open successfully. Otherwise, it has to handle the exception by throwing. The file cannot be opened. In this, we are asking the user to input the name of the file. And then based on this fname, we are opening that file. And later in this, we are trying to work using a dictionary. So create an empty dictionary. Either we use a dict or use an curly braces to create an empty dictionary. Now extract line by line from the file which we have opened. So extract the first line from the file and convert that line into an words. Use the split function or the method on the string. On this line, it converts into an words. So for each word in that words, if that word not there in the dictionary which we have created, initialize the count for that particular word as 1. If that word is already existing in the dictionary, then upgrade the count whatever is there by 1. So here we are upgrading the count by 1. Suppose we have twice the same word in the file, then it will be having the count 2 for that word, means the value 2 for that keyword, whatever the word it is, a key. This is the value because dictionary is a key value pair. So in this, to demonstrate the example, I'm using this file. So in this, you can just go through, this is the file which we are working now. We have from, here also we have from, but there is a difference between these two. There is no colon associated next to this M, but there is a colon. So these two will be two different. And excuse, here we have an mail ID of a person. The same mail ID we have here with the same. So we may get the count, we'll get the count 2 for this. If more than this, if it exists, we'll get more than that. So here we have John, and also we have John somewhere, yeah, here it's here. So we'll get the count 2. This is how it will be. If it is having some comma associated with this, then this will be different and this will be different. That is how it works. We'll execute this and we'll see what will be the output. Yeah, give the name is a file.txt. So this is what the output we get. For this from, we have a count 1. For the other from, including with a colon, we have a count 1. So very few words with the same exact match we have. That is this mail ID and this John and some more here. So that is how it works. So now you understood what is the role of a dictionary on a file. Where we can use this when we have a huge content and we need to access particular words in the file, how many times it occurs. So it will be easy if we can create a dictionary out of that file and we can access for that particular one how many occurrences of that particular word in a file. So the same program with a small modification with the method which we discussed in the last class about the get, and also I've given an assignment or the homework for you to write. Now we'll discuss by using the get method on the string now. In the last class we worked for a character. So only the changes, instead of this if else, directly we write this statement here. So get method, how it works, if this word already occurs in a dictionary, what is the value associated with that? That will be returned. If this word is not there in a dictionary, then it returns the default value 0. So that is how this get method works. Whatever the result it returns, upgrade that by 1 and store it in the dictionary. That is how it works. You can quickly execute. We'll get the same result. This is what the result we get. What we get previously, the same result we are going to get by using a get method instead. With this, it completes the files and dictionaries. Now we'll move on to the next topic, looping and dictionaries. How we are going to traverse through the dictionaries in order to access the values. So we are traversing through the keys. So for key in counts, we have a dictionary here. For key in counts, we are just accessing that key value and what is the value associated with that key. Counts of key, we get the value. So this is how it works. So suppose we want to work a comparison or relational operators on the dictionaries. How we can work? If the count, if this value is greater than 10 or whatever the value you want to check it. This is what the small modifications. If that counts of key, if it is greater than 10, only then you print those values. This is how it works. So you can use a relational operators on the dictionaries as well. So the next topic we'll be discussing on advanced text parsing. So what is this advanced text parsing? So already we discussed in the dictionaries and files. I just told you how it works. When I'm working with a huge contents, that's a file. So there may be a difference in the string. So from, there is no colon. For this from, there is a colon. It has been considered these two as two different. It need not to be only with the punctuations. Can also be the cases. If this from starts with a lowercase, uppercase, it has to find the match exactly. And no punctuations associated with it. Only then these can be a same count. Otherwise, it will be creating a dictionary with many values. So that will not be useful for us when we are working with a huge document. We all know what we expect normally, this from should be having a count too. Similarly, if anything like that, similar type of contents, let it be having a count in one shot, because always the dictionary key value should be an unique thing. So that is the drawback when we are doing an advanced text parsing. The main thing is we need to have the uniformity. We need to solve that problem. How we can solve that problem? We can use the lowercase, convert all the characters to a lowercase, remove the punctuations, and also we can use a translate method. So how this translate method works? So in order to use this translate, this is a method works on a string. In order to use this translate, we also need to create a make trans. So what is the syntax for this make trans? Make trans, it is having three parameters, from string, to string, and the delete string. So what is this from string is? It has to replace the characters in from string with the characters in the same position in two strings and delete all characters that are in delete string. That is how it works. Whatever the length of from string, the two strings should be of same length. Exactly, it replaces characters of from string with the two string. And if you are providing a delete string, it deletes all these string in the content and then it creates a table or a tabular data. That will be sent to the translate. Then we can able to work on that. That is how it works. Whenever we are providing the content or these three parameters. So here we can have this from string and two strings can be empty. So we can give a null, means an empty string. Or option delete string may not be there at all. That is how we can work. So first we'll work how this make trans will work. with a simple example here. Here we have a from string. I've given an ovals AEIOU to string. Some numbers in place of those strings means those characters. This is the string which I'm working with. So I'll first use the make trans. I've not given the delete string here since it was an option. I've just discarded that. I've just given only from string and to string. Replace all these AEIOU with the number 12345 in the string. So because this is a method on the string, make trans and translate. These are the two different methods on the string. So what is the result we are going to get after executing this? So it replaces this O is in the place here with 3. Sorry, here for this I. I is in the 3 is in the place of I. It replaced that. Then yeah, again the 3. Here A, that is place 1. So in this we don't have other characters. So it has been, this is what the results we get it after converting that or translating with the from string and to string. We also have an option that we can make this from string and to string empty and we can provide only the delete string. So what is the basic idea of doing all this? We need to exclude that punctuations. And we need to convert the entire string into a lowercase. We have to make all those things. So here we have an example. How to get that punctuations? We need to import the string method. Sorry. We need to import the string library. And then this is the constant or punctuation. It's a string constant. So see what are all the punctuations. It's been already there. We need not to do anything. So what we can do now, we can use this as the third part for this to delete string. But we need not to convert anything. So we can make these two parts as an empty. Here is an example. Already we know how to work with. Open the file. We can work with the same file. Open the file by asking the user input. We are opening a file in a read mode. And then create a dictionary. All these things we know. What is an additional and important thing which we are doing here? There we converted into words as soon as we read the line. Now we are not converting it. We are discarding the empty spaces, white spaces in the rear end of the line, that is a new line. And then we are working on this translate method. We have used this make trans. Given the from string and the to string is an empty. Delete string, we are giving the string punctuations, which is a constant, which we know all these. If it finds any of these, you just delete it. And then the new line we get. If you want, we can print this as well. And then we are converting that entire line into a lowercase. So now the all characters will be of same. It's easy to find out similar match now. Then convert the line into words. Then check for each word in that. If it is not there, upgrade the count by 1. Sorry, initialize the count by 1. If it is already there, upgrade the count by 1. We can just execute the same file. With this, we'll see what will be the results we are going to get. See now, this is what the changes. See now, so many words which are repeated. Earlier we couldn't get this result. So what's the result we get from 1? This sat also 1. Only Jan was 2. This 5 also 1, I hope. This was the result in the previous. So 5 was 2. But this is the result in the present after removing all the punctuations and the things. With this, we completed the dictionaries. Any questions, please post the questions in the WhatsApp or in the comment. Thank you. The next class will start with the tuples.